Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I'm going to show you how to install MongoDB server. Also, I will be showing you how to install MongoDB shell and how to use it. So let's start the video. So you can open any of your favorite browser and just type MongoDB download. And guys, here you can see it is showing me official website, that is mongodb.com, and here is a link. Just click on this link. So it has redirected me to MongoDB community server download page. So this is what a community server, which is freely available, open source. You can just scroll down and here it is showing me the latest version, that is 6.0.3. We have older versions also. I'm going to install the latest one. And depending on your operating system, you can select the platform. I am selecting Windows. And here we have packages MSI and zip. I will be selecting MSI. And then I will be clicking on this download button. So guys, you can see my download of MSI has been started. The file size is 482 MB. It will not take more time. You can see guys, my download has been done. Now what I'll do, I'll just click on this MSI. Okay, let me minimize my browser. Okay, so guys, my Windows installer has been started. It is showing me preparing to install. Okay, now here I need to click on next button to start my install. Guys, here I need to click on next button, and here this is the license and agreement page. So just click on this checkbox and click on next button. And guys, here it is showing me two buttons, complete setup and custom setup. So I'm going to take complete setup. And here it is showing me service configuration. So install MongoD as a service. And there are two options, run service as network service user and run service as local or domain user. So we have to take run service as network service user. It will take your Windows account authentication. And this is the service name. By this service name, your MongoDB server will run under Windows services. And guys, it is going to create two directory. One directory is for data and another directory is for log file. And this is a location for data directory and this is a location for log file. So C:\ program files MongoDB server, under that 6.0 and data, and similarly 6.0 and log. So this two folder will be created under this directory. So I don't want to change anything over here. I have to click on next button. And guys, here I need to check mark on this install MongoDB compose. So GUI interface will be installed. So just click on next button. And guys, now here I need to click on install button to start my installation. Okay, so guys, here it is asking me permission, so I'm going to click on yes button. Okay, you can see my installation is in progress. It will take while, so we will wait. Okay guys, so you can see my MongoDB compose is now getting installed. So it will launch once it is done, so we have to wait. Okay, so now here you can see I'm getting this message, welcome to compose. I'm not showing you MongoDB compose right now, so I will be just showing you MongoDB installation as well as how to use it on Mongo shell. So what I'll do, I'll just cross this. And now here it is showing me MongoDB 6.0.3 installation is done. And guys, you can see on desktop it has created icon also. So I'm just going to click on finish button. Okay, so guys, my MongoDB server has been installed. Now I will be installing MongoDB shell. So again, you can go to your browser. And now let me just type MongoDB shell. Okay guys, so here you can see it is showing me the official website mongodb.com, and here is the link MongoDB shell download. Just click on this link. Okay, it has redirected me to download page, and here it is showing me tools MongoDB shell. So you can just scroll down and here it is showing me version 1.6.1. And here we have a platform, so I'm doing for Windows, so I'm not changing it. And here we have package, only zip is available, no MSI. So I'm not changing anything, I'm just clicking on this download button. So guys, you can see here my download of Mongo shell is done now. It's very small file. So this is a zip file. So I'm going to extract this. So here I will just click on extract all button, and this is a location where it will be extracted. So I don't want it should be extracted in downloads folder. So click on browse button and then take your drive wherever you want to extract. So I'm just taking C drive. And inside this, I am creating a new folder, MongoSH. Okay, and click on select folder. So my file will be extracted in this folder. Just click on extract button. Okay, so guys, let me minimize all this thing. Here you can see this is what my Mongo shell extracted file, and here I am having bin. And here there is MongoSH. So this is a location where my MongoSH has been installed, and I will show you location of my MongoDB server also. So again, I'll go to this PC, C drive, program files, and guys, you can see here I'm having MongoDB server 6.0 bin, and here I'm having MongoD application. So this will be used for running your server. So now what I have to do, I have to set the path in environmental variable. So simply I'm going to copy this path, okay, and in search I'm going to type env, and here it's showing me edit the environmental variable. So just click on this, and now guys, under advanced tab, click on environmental variable, and here we are having path variable. Under system variable, just select that and click on edit button. And guys, here I'm going to click on new, and I will paste the copied path of my MongoDB server. Okay guys, so now after pasting MongoDB server path, I'm going to paste path of Mongo shell also. So I will be going to my C directory again, and in that I'm going to my Mongo shell folder, and then I will take this folder, and then I will select this bin, and then I'm going to copy this path. Okay, so then again I have to go back to my environmental variable, and now here I will click new button once again, and I'm going to paste my copied path. So my path of MongoDB server as well as MongoDB shell has been set. So path is set guys. Now I will be showing you MongoDB on my command prompt, whether it is running or not. Also I will be showing you its version. So here I am starting my command prompt, and guys, you can see my command prompt has been started, and now here I am going to type MongoD space hyphen hyphen version. It is showing me MongoDB 6.0.3. okay, so my MongoDB server has been installed successfully. Now I will check whether my server is running or not. So for that I'm going to simply type MongoD command and just hit enter. So guys, you can see my command prompt has written back. That means there is some problem. What is the problem? Let me tell you. So just scroll up, and there is error. It is showing me non-existent path, that is C colon data DB not found. So since I have not created this directory, this is a requirement for MongoDB server. So hence it is not starting the server. So I'll go to my C drive again, and here in this C drive I'm creating my folder data. Inside that I'm creating my folder DB. So my folder creation is done. Now I'll go back again to my command prompt, and here I will write that command again, MongoD, and hit enter. And guys, you can see my command has not written back. That means my server has been started successfully. Guys, while installation we have selected run MongoDB as services. So I will show you whether it is running in services or not. So since I have checked that it will run in services, so I don't need this MongoDB server running over here. So I'm just crossing this command prompt, and now I'm going to my this start again, and here I'm typing services. Okay, so this is going to start or show me Windows services. So guys, here it's showing me different Windows services. I'm going to just press M, and you can see where is your MongoDB server. Yeah, here it is MongoDB server. It's showing me running. So since we have selected run as services, so it is always running as soon as you start your machine. So no need to run on command prompt. Okay, so my server is running. Now what I'll do, I'll start my MongoDB shell. So I'll go to my directory of shell and here I'm starting Mongo SH. So guys, here my defender is showing me some message over here. So I'm going to select run anyway. Okay, so guys, you can see here it is showing me please enter a MongoDB connection string. This is a default. So my MongoDB server is running on my local host. So I'm going to just hit enter over here. And guys, you can see here it's showing me connecting to, that means my Mongo shell has connected to MongoDB server. This is the IP address 127.0.1 and this is the port number where my server is running to 27017, and here it's showing me version of my MongoDB and here it's showing me version of my Mongo shell. Okay, and just scroll down here, it is showing you the default database, that is the test database. So I'm not going to work on this test database. What I'll do, I'll create my own database. So guys, let me show you few commands of MongoDB. So first of all, what I'm going to do, I'm going to type over here show DBS. So this does what? This shows the different databases available. So here it's showing me admin, config and local. Let me just increase the font. Okay, so now I'm going to type another command, that is use CS Corner. So it will create a database known as CS Corner. So now guys, I'll just repeat the command again, show DBS, but you can see it's not showing me my database name, because in MongoDB you should have at least one collection. So I'm going to type a command for creating collection. So for that I'm typing db.createCollection and here I'm giving my collection name as students. Okay, so it's showing me OK1, that means my collection has been created. Now I'm going to type command show DBS. So guys, you can see now my database is also shown over here. So it's showing me CS Corner. And now what I'll do, I'll insert one record or documents to my collection. So for that I'm going to write db.students.insert1. And here I'm going to insert one record to this, one documents to this collection. So I'm just inserting roll number, that is 1. And then since it is number, I'm not putting it in double quotes. And then I'm going to write name. Okay, that will come in double quotes. Name colon. Whatever name you want to provide. So I'm just giving name as Sunita and just hit enter. So guys, it's showing me acknowledged true and it has created object ID for my documents. Now what I'm going to do, I'm going to write one command over here. So the command is what? Show collections. So it will show you all the collections in this database. So currently I'm having only one collections. So now to show the documents under this collection, I'm going to write one command, that is find command. So db dot my collection name students dot find and then I will write pretty. Okay, so that it will show me in proper format. So guys, you can see it's showing me my documents also, only one document I'm having. Now next I will show you how you can drop a collection. So for that I will write db.students.drop. So this command is going to drop my collection, and after this I will be typing again command show collections. So you can see it's not showing me any collection. Okay, then I'm going to drop my database. So db dot drop database. So it's showing me message that okay one and dropped CS corner. Okay, so guys, now if I type command show DBS, it should not show me my database name. Okay, so guys, you can see it is not showing me CS corner database. It's showing only admin, config and local. So that means it has dropped the database also. So guys, I conclude my video over here. I have tried to show you all the related commands of MongoDB. I hope you enjoyed watching my video. And guys, do let me know in comment box whether you are successfully installed MongoDB by following my video or not. And guys, if you really like my video, do hit on like button. And if you have any query, you can post in comment box or you can join my Telegram channel and share there. The link is in description box. And guys, if you are new to my channel, please subscribe to my channel. Thank you guys for watching my video till end. I'll see you in my next video. Till that, bye bye and take care.